Can we compute the sum of a series in case we do not have a geometric series? Sometimes we can, and in this video we will encounter such an example. Compute the sum of the following series. Sum n from 1 to infinity, 1 over n times n plus 1. Well, let's see whether this is a geometric series, because then we're happy. So we compute an plus 1 over an. Division by an is easy, because it's just this term over here, 1 over n times n plus 1, and the an plus 1, then you have to substitute n plus 1 for n in the expression, so we get n plus 1 times n plus 2, and you can simplify that a bit, to because the factors n plus 1 will cancel out, to n over n plus 2. But anyhow, this does depend on n. For any value of n, this will be different. For geometric series, this ratio has to be constant. It's not constant, so we do not have a geometric series. Oh, but what now? Well, we can try to separate this fraction, because then we'll see that something nice will happen. You cannot see that beforehand, of course, but well, let's just try and see what happens. So, we separate the fraction, 1 over n times n plus 1 in a times n plus b times n plus 1, don't know a and b, turn it again into one fraction, so we multiply the a over n by n plus 1 and the b over n plus 1 by n, and we can turn it again into one fraction, because the denominator is now the same, so the denominator is n times n plus 1, and you see there are all equation signs, so the a numerator here has to be equal to 1. So we see that a plus b times n plus a has to be equal to 1 plus 0 times n. So that a has to be equal to the 1 over here. And a plus b as, times n has to be equal to 0 times n. So a plus b has to be equal to 0. So we find because a equals 1, b equals minus 1. And we can factorize 1 over n times n plus 1 as 1 over n plus minus 1 over n plus 1. How does it help us? Well, let's see what happens if we work out the capital N partial sum. So S capital N is a sum from small n from 1 to capital N, 1 over n times n plus 1. We can factorize that, as we just saw. And since it is a finite sum, we can split the sum into two parts. Just a sum over a couple of terms, so you can just split it up. No infinite sum is involved yet. So this is a sum from n from 1 to capital N over 1 over n minus sum 1 over small n from 1 to capital N over 1 over n plus 1. Let's write down those terms. The sum of 1 over n yields a 1 over 1 plus a 1 over 2 plus a 1 over 3 plus a 1 over 4 plus a 1 over 5 plus up to a 1 over capital N. Next sum will start at 1 over 1 plus 1, so 1 over 2. Then we get a 1 over 2 plus 1, 1 over 3. Then we get a 1 over 4. And then we continue. If we are at a summation index small n equals capital N minus 1, we have a 1 over capital N here. And at the last point, if the small n equals the capital N, we get a 1 over capital N plus 1. And now we see something funny happen. Because we have sum minus sum, but there are lots of terms they have in common. So we have a 1 half minus a 1 half, a 1 third minus 1 third, 1 over 4 minus 1 over 4, up to a 1 over n minus a 1 over n. So the only terms we are left with is this 1 over here, and the 1 over capital N plus 1 over here. So as capital N equals to 1 minus 1 over capital N plus 1. This is what we call a telescoping series. Terms mutually cancel out, and we are left with only two terms. That means that we can compute the sum of the series, because this s is the limit capital N to infinity of s capital N. We know now this partial sum, that's always the hard part, we know it now, so we can use that, plug it in. The term over here vanishes if n goes to infinity, so we are left with an 1. So the conclusion is the sum of our series 1 over n times n plus 1 equals 1.